Hello everyone, my name is Zephra and welcome to what will become the Great Mobilization of Satsuma. So, let's have our best men be recruited. Well, the best of what we have right now. To be quite fair, it's not that much, but lots of line infantry definitely has a lot of firepower. Even if it isn't as much as, say, a 12-pounder howitzers, which we also will get. So, there we go, a huge batch of soldiers also. What kind of soldiers do I actually have here? Well, basically peacekeepers. Not that much to it. Also, you are still not used to me. Resistance to invaders still at -1. Ew, I don't like that. Oh well. So, we have a bunch of soldiers here as well. Can we recruit? Yes, we can. We can actually recruit Expeditionary Force. So that's very nice. We have this barracks. There's a nice little barracks right here. So yeah, I guess we could take what used to be one of our main armies until one of our generals died, and then have them be reinforced by Expeditionary Force, maybe Sharpshooters, I don't know. And after that, we'll take them to where they are needed, basically. And that'll probably be here. Or maybe here. Surely here. Also, I think it might be time for upgrading stuff. So first, I just want to upgrade the farms. And I think a lot of them actually are quite a bit upgraded. But I don't think all of them. There we go. Another farm needing upgrades. And we have gone all the way around. So, next up. Well, we have another slot here. So, for the sake of increased revenue, I'll go for the cottage industry. Will give us a little bit of and happiness due to modernization, but I guess we can easily balance that with a bit of repressioning forces. This is about right. Actually, we could also recruit one of these guys to keep this under control. And after that, we still have quite a lot of money. Okay, let's upgrade that. Samurai Dojo. Not really. We want to increase our income. Yeah, this reminds me of something. Can I upgrade my artillery production facility here? Yes, I can. Field Artillery School. Hopefully we can get some proper artillery. Or more proper artillery, I guess. And more recruitment slots, actually. I don't know if you really need this. It would be nice, I guess. Add a bit of repression. Add a bit of spreadage of the sentiment. But then again, these guys are actually pro-imperial, so I don't know. Don't really need the port. That's the dojo again. Let's keep on shuffling. Okay, just expand a few cities then. Actually, I think we could only afford one. Yes, that appears to be the case. So I think it might be time to end the turn. Just moving forwards a bit, and there. And, yeah, unfortunately, they captured that province, so, yeah, you have to go to a massive war here. I don't like this, but it might be, well, it's necessary if we are to capture anything. Anything close to us, anyway. Could, like, be sneaky and try to go for Hokkaido again. It's quite a valuable little place up here. Unfortunately, it's quite It's quite isolated compared to my other territories, so if I need to protect my territory when it comes to the naval aspect of the game, I pretty much have to divide my navy. And unless I spend a considerable amount of koku on that, then I will have quite a lot of troubles, actually. Anyway, we were building decent ships, weren't we? Yes, we are. And that's good, because I need transport for these guys. Am I recruiting here? Yes, I am. Okay, so another round. And you guys are also, you're actually building two rounds. And you guys, you are building two more rounds as well. But I'm actually not recruiting anything here, so just to have something to transport them on, this. Artillery, still doing fine. Actually, I'm probably not gonna recruit that much artillery. There we go. That should be enough. But yeah, I think we can afford another round. We also have Expeditionary Force, actually. I think I will take that and do that instead. Seems pretty reasonable. The Expeditionary Force are superior, so they also are superior in the fact that they do not suffer attrition during winter. So that's also very, very handy. And then there's the thing about you guys. You're gonna take quite a while to even get under control, so yeah, we'll recruit Expeditionary Force, but yeah, there will be quite a time before we can actually move out with the Expeditionary Force. Also, General. Actually, I have another General. The Sun and Air, nonetheless. That seems quite decent. I'll take him. So, you'll move out with the Line Infantry. And that should be it. Well, once again, we have a bit of cash. But right now, I'm really just focused on building up my army and getting ready to attack. Unfortunately, these guys are allies, so even if I agree with this, which I might do, these guys are probably gonna choose the Matsuyama. And I guess quite reasonable, because they actually share a border with them right now. And they do not have that great military, to be quite frank. Oh well, this is not a huge payment, so I'll make it just to get a trade agreement. But I don't think they will keep their part in that military alliance. Then again, it tends to favor the defender when it comes to the side choosing, well, basically the faction choosing their side. At least that's what I found. All the way over here. Hmm. I don't think you need him here, really. Yeah, so that's probably a unit that was actually keeping up with one of our armies. And once we captured Nagasaki, we just completely forgot to move him. Quite usual for me, unfortunately. Can get on to go to island. That might be a good idea. This island definitely needs a bit of the message about the Emperor. Have you heard about our Lord and Savior, the Emperor? Well, you surely will quite soon. Hmm. I really don't need the entire navy for this, but I guess you're lucky. You are a port, so fix you. What is your bidding? Also, send this guy to join our main navy. And our agent is actually still on that ship, so make sure that he get on and does his job. And just doesn't sit back and slack on the ship. There we go, more navy. But we're still waiting for more troops. I think we'll go for one more round of Expeditionary Force, and that should be good. Our first set of artillery is almost done. Not quite yet, though. I'll build this, so I get increased recruitment capacity, and hopefully that'll build our... Well, I know it will build our artillery quicker, so that's why I'm doing it. Anything else, really? I don't know. I don't think so. Well, what about you guys? Maybe I should go for a barracks? 4 turns? Yeah, sure. I don't know, though. It really depends on... I don't know how useful this will really be, eventually, because... Once I continue to push further eastward, this will become further and further from the front, and... As you may have noticed, there's no railways here, and we do not have that start when basically we had the railway as, well, actually passing through the second province we got in the Josai campaign. So I don't know. I don't know how useful that will really be, and once I, when I play as Tosha, I think I rarely used units that were actually from here. Oh well, we'll still build it, and well, why not? All we are doing is basically just saving money with that, and we are using quite a lot of money, so we're not really in a saving mood, are we? Anyway, that should be it for that turn. Also, how far are we along with our technology? I need to know. Should be close to actually getting done with that. Let's see, clan development. Oh, yes, I was quite right. So, a quite nice income booster. And, as I promised, after that we'll go over to the imported guns. So we can actually get ourselves more arsenal guns, which are quite awesome. And eventually... Yeah, we'll probably grab these two. And maybe modern army? I don't know, though. I'll probably find something else that will distract me. Actually, recruit more artillery, and with when these two are in production, I should have finished this, which means that should actually be recruited at the same time. So that should surely be enough artillery for the armies we have. So when it comes to armies we already have, how are things looking over here? Better, but not by much, that's for sure. What about now? 8. Okay, so if I do that, it will be it will give me -4. Yes, so they will still be a bit unhappy, but we can move a bit of the army out and actually still be on the safe side. Actually, let's keep the forces in that haven't replenished properly. Is that all, sir? 7. Okay, so we can move a few more units out. Once they have fully replenished. Might take some time though. I don't know. Ready for orders. There we go. Our transport navy is up and running. Along with our other ships, our newly built ships. Actually, now that we are actually using quite a lot of money to just build up our entire army, let's do the same with our navy and pump out the best ships we can build at the moment. The couple-rated frigate, the Kaijo Maru. Except the ironclad, of course. But like, technically I didn't build that, I recruited it. So... Like, technically, the best ship I can build is a Kaijo Maru. And the rest are just imported. Well, one of them are imported. What kind of armor do I have here? Well, basically filler. And happiness, +5, that means that just about that can easily be just gotten rid of. You're not needed anymore. Actually, they won't be needed once the happiness from modernization goes up. But yeah, it should level out. And also they have a bit of resistance to invaders to burn off. So I should be good there. Do I want to launch this now? Not really. So unfortunately this might be a very boring episode, but you should be you should relax and just think that this is leading up to a big war. I'll definitely be in a spot of trouble here, seeing that I'm pretty much going to war with this entire island, and... Let's see, here, there. There's quite a huge chunk of land that I'm actually trying to capture here. Anyway, am I still recruiting you? No, I am not. That means it is time to move out. Also, we might actually have 3 armies on our hands, meaning that guy right there, which up to now hasn't had that much to do, might actually have something to do. And yeah, let's recruit a tiny little transport ship and get him over there. What good? Building anything else? Nope. Let's move you out then. With the actually useful units. And you can just easily cross the straits. But you are damn slow, so that will actually take quite a while. 3 turns? Yeah, I'm on the same turn. Let's see, anything here? I guess we could recruit Ronin. Might be a good idea. We'll just recruit spare units. I haven't really been using them, and because I'm not using them, my line infantry tends to be promptly charged by cavalry, and they tend to do quite a lot of damage. So maybe we'll build a few Yari attendants. Oh, they will take a turn each. Well, sure. Go ahead. So, let's see how huge will our income boost be. It really depends. I have seen it be quite massive. And sometimes not that massive, but this time it was quite massive indeed. Mounting unrest? Okay. Yes, as I said, in happiness from modernization, we'll start to take a toll. And it's starting here. My sword for you as you command. Full speed ahead. Have you joined them? You guys, are you ready? Well, you're not ready, but you have been recruited. Just get him out there. Are we recruiting anymore? No, we aren't. I think I will, because obviously we are. We need at least one more turn here. Anything else? Artillery, why not? Also, that should be 3 artillery, right? Yes, 0 upkeep cost. Ah, the glory. So glorious. I do actually have a Yari catcher here. Oh yes, that's the one I bought off, isn't it? Well, let's have them join the Yaris. Happiness at 2, so you can actually stay there. And the resistance to invaders are actually quite long-lasting, apparently. And it's staying at -1 for quite a long time there. Let's see. I can't unload these guys. Oh yeah, I have to select the navy. Okay, that didn't work either. Let's have them join. Them get there, and that should work. And indeed it did. Let's get on and merge them. Can you move? No. Apparently you can't move after you've let those guys over. Oh well. Let's see. I stopped recruiting air, right? No, I didn't. But the boat left. We'll have this guy come help. There we go, and drop him off there. Ready for orders. Leading the ship. Up to your side. And let the artillery over. Make haste, man. Up to your command. Up to your command. There we go, used all the movement points. You guys are very soon ready to move out. That's very nice. Up I didn't move you yet. Well, let's fix that. So yeah, we are very soon ready to start the invasion. So yeah, I think I will focus on the mainland here. Well, I guess, once again, everything in Japan is our islands, but you know what I mean, Honshu, the main islands. So yeah, I'll focus on that first, and after that, take that island, which I can't remember the name of, and actually, one of the regions are in rebellion, it seems like, because it's not really, it doesn't really have a color. Do I need you? Well, I'm down to 3 generals, and even though I might not have 4 armies, it would definitely be a pretty decent idea to have one in reserve right now, seeing that when I get more of this, I can give these guys more commissions. We're looking quite stylish there. 27 years of age. Probably not gonna look that stylish myself when I'm that age. Can pretty much guarantee it. Oh, son has just been born, so he's not becoming a general anytime soon, unfortunately. How old are you? You're 50. Yeah, so you're starting to get a bit old. Well, you're starting to get within the range of me slightly worrying about you dying from natural causes. Not too much, but it might happen. Let's see. There we go. 1 piece army. And there we go. So that's the beginning of the second army. Well, I guess the third army, because this is definitely the first army. Also, do I need to, or can I recruit units here? Yes, I can recruit Yari attendants, so 3, because we actually are making quite a few of them here. I think I'll recruit 2 more, actually, and then we'll move out. Speaking of moving out, we are ready to do so here. Merge you guys. Merge with them. And move out. Actually, we might have enough. We might have enough army for the new general to actually have one. Because this guy already has pretty much a full army. And we still have artillery being built right here. And who knows, we might cram in a few more units. So yes, I think we actually have potential for maybe not the full 4th army, but definitely a few forces that this man right there can actually command. And who knows, maybe I'll use them to invade something here. But then again, I don't think 1 army is enough here. So maybe we'll just send 2 armies up here, 2 armies here, 2 armies in here, and then 2 armies just going into the next province, and so on. We'll see. But yeah, I think this guy can actually get some stuff to do. There we go. Do the same with him as we did with this guy. And yeah, move out. And unload. Just want to merge these guys. Oh yeah, I unloaded those guys this part. Or this turn, rather. And we will soon be ready to attack. It's getting closer by the day. Closer by the turn. Also, house control here. Barely keeping it in control. Thankfully, we are flipping them. Not that fast, but, well, 5% per turn. I guess that's decent. Still can't get them to pay taxes, though. Also, I have these guys under control, so that's quite nice. Clan development. Oh, yeah, I didn't actually give these guys a new thing to do, and then I hit the wrong tab. Okay, I could go for this. That will lower my monetization. It will allow me to build a municipality, though. That might be a very good idea. But I did actually promise that I would start building the imported guns. So that's what I'll do. Yes. Okay. We've got a few more copper-plated ships. That's always nice. Okay, we have a full navy here. And we're starting to build up our second stack right there. There we go. So how many ships? 8, right? No. Actually 10. So we're halfway to build a full navy. Not full navy when it comes to potential strength, but still. And then one more guy, and then we are ready. Well, when this guy actually gets there. There we go. Okay, so to get control over all of this. Actually, we are still building artillery, aren't we? So let's see. No, apparently I was wrong. Apparently I didn't get another recruitment slot. You lied to me. You lied to us all. Yeah, so that didn't happen. That's unfortunate. But I think we should be getting enough artillery, to be quite frank. But yeah, we should still just ferry them over. Okay, so you guys, you have not that much artillery, but you have enough artillery for an army. So let's start moving you up. You guys, should you be following the daimyo, or should you be following in the other way? Well, you're my son and heir, so you are definitely going your separate way. Which attack will be most important? I believe it will be this, seeing that we kind of had the most provinces here to actually capture. So I think I'll send this army with these guys. Then I guess this last army will actually have quite a few artillery units. Actually, let's just have them stay here because I forgot to give them the Yari attendants that I'm been recruiting. Also, we actually had some Yari units here. And I don't have enough movement point to do so. Okay then. Anyway, let's continue to build up that army. I guess I'll give you the artillery and also give you the general. And he is right here. Blocked, actually. Well, let's fix that. And there we go. Fixed. So, one more turn, and these guys are ready to move out. And also, spring is arriving, so we're getting in the season. There we go, spring. Beautiful time of year. Especially in Japan, I've heard. The cherry blossom and all of that. Your next command, ready and wait. Disembarking now. All hands on deck. Okay. Last Lari unit. Yes, Yari unit. Have them join as well. And I can't merge them. And I can't merge these guys either. Can merge you though. But you have almost a full unit there. Also, a full army there, sorry. This is a quite decent army. Even without the R units, I think I can manage. So this is just gonna stay how it is, but these armies are gonna get their fair share of R units. So I am gonna try to make that fair. Anyway, end the turn again. Oh yeah, these guys had a movement order and I, of course, forgot to cancel it. You made a poor decision there, Yonago. You'll regret it. Let's see, let's just move these guys out of the way to make it a bit clearer. Okay. So, you guys, you get another Yari unit. Actually, these guys can't move any further. But we'll do it like this, give these guys one of those. And do the same with these guys, so they actually have space for that new unit. Also, let's see. In one turn, we'll get a new set of artillery. And these guys don't actually have any artillery. So let's do like this. And that'll give them the space to get these two new artillery pieces. And that means that this army has artillery. This army definitely has artillery. This army has artillery. And this army will, as I said, have artillery. Except for the mortars that they already had, but I don't really like mortars. I guess they're effective, but I think they could be a bit more effective. Also, what's this barrage here? Where is this going to? This is surely a glitch. Oh, all the way over here? This is exciting. Not really, but it's unlikely. That's definitely the case. Yeah, this is boring. Nothing to really look at. I guess we also are recruiting Yari units here, so I think we actually have more units than we really need for the armies we have. Let's just take a look. Yes, that is too much. We have a full army already. Same here, really. Well, we did actually let the unit go, so I guess you'll be the ones that actually replaces that guy. You guys are ready. And I think... How will we do that? Let's give you one more. We might actually not have the space for it, but let's try. And have you guys follow up there. So yes, I'm sorry for this being quite a boring part, but you can't have action all the time. And when you have action all the time, it's usually because you are losing. As I found out. And that is not fun. Actually has quite a lot of movement for dragging a set of artillery pieces along. I'll give him that. There we go, next turn, we'll get that. Also, main navy. Let's set you guys up in bombardment range. Quite nice, we're ready to go. And actually do the same with this navy. So yeah, we are definitely ready. I'll just get us to where we are actually ready to invade. And we'll start invasion on the next part. There we go. Ready for orders. I definitely gave you a movement order up here. Got path blocked by something. That's interesting. I don't really know what you got movement blocked by. But oh well. And with that, I actually think we have full armies. We can't actually give him any more units. Except this guy. I think, yes. So, yeah, one more turn with both of them, actually. And we will end. Also, I know I have actually gained quite a large treasury. So, in between parts, I will just try to spend as many as possible, just upgrading random stuff. And, oh yeah, that was actually a good timing. Because we gain the next level of artillery piecework. So, now it's time to build it. Like that one. And there is it, right in the middle there, Armstrong guns. pretty much the best artillery you can get, quite frankly, even with this artillery mod I'm using. Anyway, that is it for now. Once again, I apologize for the lack of action, but you will definitely be seeing quite a lot of action in the next part, and the next part after that as well. So, I hope you enjoyed this part nonetheless, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Goodbye.